Hi and welcome to the next video. This is video number 12 and here we will handle just some Nest.js stuff. We want to inform all users of a new created room with socket.io after the room was created, and we also want to save all the socket.io connections to the database, and when the user disconnects with this connection, and we also want to delete this entry from the database. Before we start, I have to say here, if we for example shut down this application later, then we don't get remove these connections from the database. So if you then reconnect with the user, you will get an error, so you have then to clean like the table. But normally if the user disconnect directly or normally, then everything works fine. So this is something you will refactor in video number 13, I think. So our structure is as always, we want to have a look at the video outcome first. Then we read the user story for this, and then we implement the story and close it. Hi, so let's have a short look at the outcome of this video. So you can see it here. We are here connected with the user Thomas, here with Walter, and here with Sam. So when we now create like a new room, and let's name it, for example, real-time room. We give it a description, and we want to just add, for example, let's say Walter to it, and then let's see it here so that you can see everything. And now if I create the room, you can see it immediately here. Walter gets like the new room, and Sam still has his normal rooms because he's not listening in this real-time room. So this works. You see it here. We have just the users Walter and the users Thomas in this room. So this is what we will create in this video. So let's have a short look at our story here first. So we are here in video number 12. And we are just doing some Nest.js stuff here. So we want to emit a created room to all of its users after it is created. So the story is as follows. As a user, I want to automatically have a new room where I am listed as a user displayed on my dashboard in real time after creation. So to make it a little bit easier to understand, if user A creates a new chat room with user B, then user B should see this chat room immediately on his dashboard after this room is created. So we want to use like the socket.io connection that we already have to see if the user is connected, user B for example, and if he is connected, then we send him like the new list of rooms. Then we have some acceptance criteria here. So we want to create a new entity, connected user entity, where we have a one-to-one relationship with our users. We want to save the socket ID in the new entity, and we want to save this on the on-handle connection. So every time that someone connects with our gateway, with socket.io, we want to save this socket ID with the user ID into our database. And the same goes when he disconnects. We want to delete this whole entry from our table. So then at the end, we can notify all users within the room when a new room is created and they are actually online, so they are in our database. So let's go into our API folder. And the first thing that we need to do is we want to create like an entity. So we can go to here to our terminal, and we can cd into our API folder, and we can just use the Nest.js CLI, and we can say nest generate, or actually we don't need it for this, so we can just make new file and we say connected user.entity.ts. And we can also make a connected user.interface.ts. So in our entity, we can simply say export class connected user entity. And we can annotate it with add entity from type ORM. And then we like always have like an ID. And this is our add primary generated column, also from type ORM, so this is just getting counted up. Then we have our socket ID, which is a string and a column, of course. And then we have our user, which is a relationship to our user entity. And here we have like a one-to-one relationship. To our user entity. And we want to make join column so that we have here like a user ID column in this table. So every user can have like one connection, and then we can work with this. Then we can do like the same stuff in our interface. So we can say export interface connected user interface. We have like an ID optional. We have like our socket ID, which is a string. And we have our user, which is a user interface. And then this is our interface. The next thing that we need is like a service where we can handle all the stuff that we do with our repository. So we can say nest generate service. And then we want to go into our chat module. We want to go into our service folder. And then we want to name it, for example, connected user. And then this should create here like a connected user service for us. Now you see we have here our connected user service. And we can, our room service is actually nested in another room, so we can just move this and we can delete the empty room folder then. And I think then we have to update here path where it is used, and I think we are also using this in our gateway, so we also have to update it here, and then this should be fine again. Always see here everything is correct, and then in our chat module we also want to have our type ORM for feature for our connected user entity. And you can see it here in our providers. We already have now our connected user service since we were using the Nest.js schematics or CLI. And now we can add all the functions that we need to our connected user service. So at first we need to inject our repository. So we need our constructor. Oops, my mistake. So we can say add inject repository. And we want to do this for the connected user entity, and then we name private read-only connected user repository, and this is our repository from type ORM for our connected user entity, and then we can use it simple. And so we normally just need like a three functions, so we need one where we create like a connection. So we can say create and we get a connected user from connected user interface. And we want to return like a promise from a connected user interface. So we return this dot connected user repository dot save, and then we save our connected user. Then we need something to find by our user, so we can name it find by user, and we get like the user interface or a user, and then we want to return like all the connections, so connected user interface as an array, and we can say return this dot connected user repository dot find. And we want to find by user. So this goes because we named it like the same. And then we have like another where we want to delete when, for example, the connection gets disconnected. So we want to delete by socket ID. So we get socket ID, which is a string. And then we want to return this dot connected user repository dot delete, and we want to find it or delete it by the socket ID. So then this is all that we need here, and now we can go to our chat gateway, and here we have our handle connection. At the moment we are just adding here our user that we got from the database, if the token was correct, to our data from the socket. Then we get the rooms, and then we emit like a new rooms event to this specific socket ID from the connection. And now we also want to store the socket connection into our database. So we can say save connection to database. So we can simply say await this.connectedService, which we then need in our constructor. So we can say private connected user service, connected user service. And then we can say await this.connected user service dot now we want to create. And so we can, he wants a connected user. And for this, we can give him the socket ID, which is our socket.id. And of course, our user that we got here from the database. And then we can save it. And we can also go into handle disconnect, which is here called on gateway disconnect. We can simply make this also async. And then we can say remove connection from DB. And then we can say await this dot connected user service dot delete by socket ID. And then we have simply here our socket ID that we got here from the disconnect. So always, for example, if the user closes his browser, whatever, then this fires and then we can remove this. And then we have to modify here our create room. But let's first check if we are saving and deleting it correctly when we are connecting or not. So for this, we have to look into our database. As you remember, this was all set up at the beginning. So that we are using like a Postgres database. And we have here the Postgres adminer. And the admin at admin.com is the admin account that we also specified in our Docker Compose file. And here we can just connect to our database server. So let's call it just test. Then we have our Postgres database. And we can save this connection. And then we can see here our database. So we have here our DB database. We can see our tables. And now we see that we have a new connected user entity. And we can use, for example, our query tool. And we can say select all from connected user entity. And now there's actually, you see, we have here the ID, the socket ID, and the user ID. And now it's empty. So if I am here now on my front end and I log in with my basic account, then I should now see here when I make a new thing that I see now my ID is 1, my socket ID is also stored in my user ID. And now if I, for example, just close this here and I run this query again, then you see it's here gone away. So this seems to work. So now we have to modify here our create room so that we can send like the rooms to all the users that are in this room. So right now we are like returning here promise room interface, which actually we don't need. So the first thing that we need is like, we want to have, or you want to create our room. So we can say our created room, which is the room interface. And then we create this normally, exactly like we did here before. And then we have created our rooms with all the users. And now we want to check if our users are like connected. So what we can do is, we can make a for loop and we can say const user of created room dot users. So we loop over them and then we can get like all the connections, which is like connected user interface. So we can have many connections or an array. And then we say await this dot connected user service dot find by user, and then we just give him the user that we have here that we are looping over. So when he will search for like for example the user ID. And then we need to get the rooms. So we can say await this dot room service dot get rooms for user. Then we are needing here the user ID. And we have to specify the pagination. So we can go here with the base pagination. So first page and first and only 10 entries. And then we have to loop over the connection. So we can say we loop over the connection, and then for every connection we want to emit the rooms. So we say const connection of connections. And then we can simply await this dot server dot to, and then this to a connected socket ID. So in this case, from our connection that we got from the database dot socket ID. And to this, we then want to emit like a rooms event with the rooms that we found for this user. Now we can like reformat here everything. And now we can have a look if it's been done correctly. So when we go to localhost, if I log in here with my user, I say password and have it here. And then I make a new private room and I log in with, for example, the SAM account, sam@sam.com. Now you see he is in two rooms here, so totally fine. And then if I create with my Thomas user here, like a new room, let's call it weekend description. And then we search by username and we want to add like Sam to it. Then we create the room. You can see it here. It seems to work because we directly get here like the new room. And then you can see it here. Let's make it full screen. We have the weekend description, and we have the users. And for example, when we make it like this and I make another private tab, and then let's have a quick look what username else we Walter, for example. And if I log in here with Walter@walter.com password, and then this, you can see here Walter is just in the weekend one. So now when I say, for example, let's reload this so that we can see everything here on one page. So, and another private window, and then we go with walter@walter.com. We go with password. So then we have like here the users, and then I now create like here a new room. Let's say Friday, and we say description, and we want just to add, for example, Walter. So this room here, so this user here, and you see we have directly here the new chat room, and he is not getting notified, so just the users that are in this room get notified. So I think we can change this here or close this here. So let's have a quick look at our story. So we can see here we have created our new entity. We are saving the socket ID. We are saving the connected users on handle connection. We also remove them on disconnection. And we notify all the users in the room when a room is created. So now we can say git add upper A, and we can commit it. And we can say video 12 Added connected user entity and save socket ID on handle connection and delete on handle disconnection. Also emit rooms to all users of or emit new room to all users of the room on creation. And we can push it. And so in the next videos we can see therefore some bugs maybe that we can fix. So we have seen that sometimes it was not working completely directly, and so we can fix this.